Chinese lacquer tree produce sap to protect themselves. When they get cut, they will bleed as people will do. Their blood, however, is sap. When people in ancient China discovered this phenomenon, they figured out ways to use it. The trees are cultivated and tapped for their sap, which is used as a highly durable lacquer to make Chinese lacquerware. This process is done by cutting 5 to 10 horizontal lines on the trunk of 10-year-old trees, and then collecting the dark yellow sap that comes out. The sap is then filtered, heat treated, and colored before being applied to a base material that is to be lacquered.
Hey, Roseann.
Yeah?
Are you okay?
I'm feeling a little better. I just need to get away from the fumes.
Because you're quite sick. I figured out how about we do a game.
Ah, we're going to play a game. This is going to make me feel better?
I think so.
What kind of game is it?
Actually, the game is from this Lanting Xi, all right?
Uh-huh.
The Orchid Pavilion Preface.
The most famous story about lacquerware is recorded in the poem The Orchid Pavilion, written by Wang Sizhe, a poem about 1,500 years ago. In this article, a tasteful literati activity which took place in the Orchid Pavilion is elaborated. 42 literati gathered sitting by the waterside and drinking in succession from a cup floating down the curving stream. If the cup stopped before one of the persons, he must improvise a poem. But if he failed to compose one, he had to drink the cup of wine. The cups they used to hold the wine were made of lacquer, and it's said that because of the exquisite shape and pattern of the lacquer cup, these poets had the inspiration to play the game and thus became the beautiful poem that passed down through history.